In this video, we're gonna play with date function in Excel to find days until your birthday. Hey guys, welcome to Excel Tutorial channel, and today we're gonna experiment or apply all date functions knowledge which we have covered until now in our date and time functions playlist. So we're gonna apply those formulas or functions in this video to find days until birthday. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do it, because in the upcoming days, years, months, we're gonna cover so much about the Excel and also cover the basics to the advanced. So let's get started. So we have here employee list here, which is very basic. If you are current subscriber of my channel, you have known about this. And if you want to download this particular spreadsheet, you can also find the link in the description box. So here we have employee and date of birth of these employees, and here I have left these blank columns here, and to find it to today's date and next birthday and days until birthday. So to calculate the number of days until your birthday in Excel, we need to execute these three column steps. First, we have a date of birth here, as you can see also. And now for the today's date, we have a simple formula for that, which is today's, right? And here we got the 9th of July 2021, and we apply to all here, and the next is next birthday. So today is very straightforward, as we have completed like this. And the next birthday will be very tricky, because we're gonna find the next birthday. When will be the our next birthday for this particular employee, which is the Joseph 12/17/1990. Okay, so next birthday will be on 12/17/2021, right? And for that, what we need to do is we need to apply a formula here with the help of date function. So how are we gonna do that? To find the next birthday, we need to apply date function here first. And now we have three arguments here, which we gonna include the three function in between this, which is the year, right? And for the year part, we need to select this serial number, which is the argument, or you can say a date after this selection. So as you know, the year function in this particular argument, it will extract which year, 1990, but we needed 2021 here. So we will add this to date diff, or we can also add, you know, the random number, which is 21, as we can find the difference between the two dates, but it won't automate your task in the future. So if you want to do it every year, so it not gonna be a compatible, because you have to change all values here which we're gonna include in the future. And so to automate that stuff, we have entered the date diff function here. And if you haven't watched that date diff function, please do it, because we have covered in this playlist, and we have also covered the limitations of it. So in the date diff, as we know, we have two arguments, main arguments here, and third will be our denoter, which is either month, day or year. And for the two differences, we need to select the start date and the end date. And the start date is here and end date is here. And what we need is here, and we close it down here. Right now, we have got the date differences here from the 90 to 2021, right? And we're gonna apply the comma here. And for the next part, we need the month of obviously this date and day here. Obviously this day, and close the parenthesis here, and there you go. As you can see, the next birthday is written as the 2020 here, and if you apply to all, it says yes. As you can see, these birthdays are gone, right? So today's date is this, and next birthday is saying 3rd, which is the March of 29, which has gone. It's not a next birthday here. So to correct that, let me just enter Ctrl+Z. And to correct that, we need to add one more year here. Why? Because it has completed, as we can see, it has completed 30 years here, but it's not giving us the right number here, because the next birthday should be 2021. If 30 years completed years have passed since the date of birth, which is 17th of December 1990, which means, in other words, you have already celebrated that birthday, right? Which is the last year of 2020. And so you, for your next birthday, we need to add +1 here to include the next year itself, which is the current year. So we will add the +1 here and close it down. So yes, the next Bday is here, and we apply to all our employees. So some will say to 2022. Why? Because next Bday will be that, because it has already passed on March of 5th 2021, right? So now this is the part where we have find the next Bday date here, and in the next part we're gonna find the days left until next Bday. And for that we have a formula, right? The day diff formula. So we need to apply day diff. As you know, day diff is not included in Microsoft Excel repository, so you have to apply. Why it hasn't included, we have covered in that day diff video. You do watch it because it's very important, and it's also an important function barring its limitation. And we open the parentheses here. So we have the two main argument here, which is the start date and the end date. So here we have a start date as a B2, which is the current, and end date as a the next Bday. And what we need here is only day, so we will apply just D here and close the parentheses. There you go, you got 161 Bdays left for Joseph. And if you apply to all here, you may find these much days has left until their next Bday. Hope you get the point how you can find these days until next Bday with the help of these little functions here, which we have covered in date function and date diff function. So hope you get the value of date diff functions here to find such stuff in your daily Excel life. Hope you get the point. If you get the point, please click the like button. If you want to subscribe more, watch more, then please subscribe it. If you want to, you have some questions in mind, if you want to ask me something, you have all comment box with you. And see you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.